Henry's law is one of the gas laws, formulated by the British chemist, William Henry, in 1803. He stated that, at a constant temperature, the amount of dissolved gas, in a liquid, is proportional to its partial pressure, above the liquid. That means, P proportional to C. Or, P equal to KH times C. Where, P is the partial pressure of the gas above the solution. C is the amount of the gas that dissolves in liquid. And KH is the Henry's law proportionality constant. The value of KH depends on the nature of the gas and solvent. That means, the solubility of gases depends on the pressure. An increase in pressure increases solubility, whereas a decrease in pressure decreases solubility. Explanation. When liquid and gas are combined in a closed vessel, a dynamic equilibrium exists between the gas molecules and those in liquid. If the pressure in the vessel is increased by decreasing the volume of the container, the solubility of the gas in the liquid increases. As the pressure of the gas above the liquid increased to double, the gas molecules become more soluble in the solvent. Because increasing pressure accelerates more collisions between the gas molecules and the solvent, thus the rate of dissolution increases. So, a new equilibrium is established with a greater amount of dissolved gas. We can also explain this law another way. As we know, each gas has its own pressure. The solubility of gas increases as the partial pressure of a gas above the liquid increases. Suppose a certain volume of liquid is in a closed container with the space above it occupied by gas at standard pressure. Some of the gas molecules come into contact with the surface of the liquid and dissolve into the liquid. If more gas is added to the space above the surface of the solution, causing a pressure increase. More gas molecules are now in contact with the liquid, and so, more of them dissolve. Thus the solubility increases as the pressure increases. If gas molecules increase double, more gas molecules are in contact with the liquid. So, the increase of pressure will be double. Importance of KH value. As we know, P equal to KH times C, or C proportional to inverse KH, when P equal to 1. Thus, Henry's law constant is inversely proportional to the solubility. So, a small value of KH indicates the high solubility, whereas a high value indicates the low solubility. If gas solubility is plotted against pressure at a given temperature, a straight line passes through origin is obtained. The slope of each line is equal to the Henry's law constant for the gas at that temperature. Henry's law constant of three gases in water at 298.15 Kelvin is given below. Herein, we see that, as the oxygen has lower value of KH compared to nitrogen and helium at given temperature, so it is more soluble than nitrogen and helium. Limitations. Number 1. Solubility of gases in liquid should not be too much. In dilute aqueous systems, at moderate pressures and temperature, most gases obey Henry's law, especially if they are not very soluble. Number 2. The pressure of the gas is not too high and temperature is not too low. Up to 100 atm, the nitrogen plot obeys Henry's law and is essentially linear. Above 100 atm, the nitrogen plot shows increasing deviations from the Henry's law line. Hydrogen obeys Henry's law up to 200 atmosphere. Number 3. The gas should not react chemically with the solvent. When the dissolving gas reacts in water, for example, carbon dioxide, the law is only applicable to that portion of gas which is in the free or uncombined state in the solution. Number 4. The gas should not undergo association or dissociation in the solution. For example, ammonia or hydrochloric acid, which react with water, do not obey Henry's law, such as ammonia reacts with water by a dissociation reaction to generate ammonium ion and hydroxyl ions. Applications. In production of carbonated beverages, the solubility of carbon dioxide in the beverage is directly related to the partial pressure of the carbon dioxide above the liquid. Before the bottle is opened, the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is high, greater than 1 atmospheric pressure. The system is at equilibrium, and a large amount of carbon dioxide is dissolved. When the bottle is opened, the pressure is released, and bubbles of carbon dioxide form within the liquid and rise to surface. After some time, a new equilibrium between dissolved carbon dioxide and atmospheric carbon dioxide is reached. In underwater diving, Henry's law has important consequences in scuba diving. Scuba tanks are filled with compressed, purified air. This air contains about 21% oxygen, 78% nitrogen, and 1% other trace gases. In the deep sea, the pressure is higher than at the surface of the water. If pressure increases, solubility of gases also increases. The deeper a diver goes underwater, the greater the pressure, and the more gas dissolved in his or her blood. Divers breathe compressed air that contains nitrogen. At higher pressure underwater, the nitrogen gas goes into the body's blood and tissues. This doesn't cause a problem when a diver is down in the water. And if a diver rises to the surface at the right rate, the nitrogen can slowly and safely leave the body through the lungs. But if a diver rises too quickly, the nitrogen forms bubbles in the body. This can cause tissue and nerve damage. This condition is known as the bends. To avoid this, diver uses oxygen diluted with helium. For climbers, at sea level, the partial pressure of oxygen is higher than high altitudes. Oxygen molecules are further apart at high altitudes because there is no sufficient pressure to push them together. So, there are fewer molecules of oxygen present in the same volume of air for inhaling. When climbers travel to high-altitude environments, sometimes they suffer high-altitude sickness, such as hypoxia, anoxia, due to the lack of oxygen. That is why climbers carry oxygen with them. If you do like my channel, please subscribe, comment, share the videos to your friends and like them.